Lovely to see you.
Fist bump. Oh, yeah, you're right. Yes.
No cash for us, Rage. Nice. No cash.
What's
for
up?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Sydney in the house. Come for, I got to talk to my piece. I got to talk to my piece. Yes. Thanks for coming out. Thanks for coming out on a Sunday night live.
This is it. This is what you do. Mm. Wherever you go, it is wild. It is bananas. It is intense. It is awesome. Big premiere yesterday. How was it for you?
Was a great energy. Mm. I had a blast. It's not true. Not everywhere I go.
Are you okay, by the way? Are you exhausted? Are you good?
What do you mean? Do I seem out of breath?
No.
I could do it. I could do a whole nother entrance if you want to. I'm not going! Now I'm a little winded.
Well, we saw you on the red carpet yesterday for the big premiere for Kung Fu Panda 4. And I'm going to be honest, you're doing a lot of kung fu moves on the red carpet. How hard is it to do, you know, kung fu in chinos? Should you have worn a looser pant?
I was wearing... No, those were actually jeans. Those were stretchy jeans.
Oh, stretch, okay.
No, I do. I tell my stylist that I need stretchy pants because I do get some kicks. I've ripped a couple butts out of my pants before. So I learned my lesson hard.
Now, kids absolutely love Poe, but do you have a hard time convincing them that you are the same person?
You know, that's a good question, Rachel. I think that kids love the voice of Poe. They love the character of Poe. They love the artwork of Poe, because the panda is an amazing creature up on a screen. Symmetrical, beautiful, hilarious. It's the parents that are like, do you know who that is? Alfred, do you know that? That's the Kung Fu Panda. And the kids are always like, that's not the Kung Fu Panda.
Alfred has such an attitude, doesn't it?
But yeah, I have to do some convincing sometimes. You know, if I give them the skadoosh, they'll know it's me.
There you go.
My kids have been Kung Fu kicking all night since seeing you.
You're
very agile.
Thank you.
Extremely
I do some
agile
stretches. I get some warm-ups.
You didn't pull anything yesterday?
No. I've been doing martial arts since I was a kid, so I guess I've got it in my bones.
It's been 8 years since the last Kung Fu Panda film, and this time round, your character Poe is moving from dragon warrior to wise spiritual leader.
Yeah.
So do you have any wisdom, Jack Black, that you like to
share? Oh, my gosh. Maybe I do. I don't really think that I have wisdom so much as just... sort of a philosophy on following the joy. You know what I mean? I'm not the smartest cookie of the bunch, but I know how to have a good time, and I feel like I'm at my best when I'm in a state of joy and fun and play. A lot like Poe, the Kung Fu Panda.
That's what I love about what you do. Even though it's been a while since we've had Poe on our big screens, you still, like, you put everything into this. Like, you know you're not physically acting in the role, but you bring it when you're in that voice booth. Is it nice to not have to stretch, though, when you're just doing the voices?
Oh, I stretch, dude. No, I move when I'm in the booth, because when Poe is active, I have to be active to make the voice match the action on screen. I get physical. But, yeah, it's been an amazing journey. For the last 16 years, I've been partying with Poe, and I can't get enough, to be honest with you.
But you've been on a real journey with this character, because the magical thing about kids' films is there's so much learning, there's beautiful messages, you know, we're getting comfortable with the idea of change and building trust in people. When you are playing that character, evolving and growing in that way, does it kind of feel like you're getting paid to go to therapy?
I kind of feel like I'm getting paid to, you know, do what I love, which I feel very fortunate. And yeah, the growth of the character has been kind of a beautiful thing. It's because I've grown up with Poe in a way, even though I started when I was in my mid to late 30s. I was already fully grown, but I still feel like I've matured along with the character.
Hey, as part of the movie, you've released a pretty epic cover of a pretty epic song.
Oh,
and I think
you.
We've got a little bit here to show everyone.
Got a little taste? Loneliness is killing me.
Has
You see that? Give him the double shot.
Has Britney reached out? Has she seen this? She heard it?
I sent a message to her through our managements, and I told her how much of a fan I was of her and of the track, and that we were proud of our cover, and I hope she likes it too. And I heard that she read my email, and she said, thank you. Oh. But I've not met her face to face. I hope to collab with her in person someday. That would be cool. It'd be cool to have a live performance, Britney and Tenacious D. That'd be a mind blower.
She would destroy Wonder Boy. I think she'd be great at that. That's my daughter's favorite song.
We'd have to play some bigger venues. look out, Taylor Swifties. Here comes the D plus Britney.
Any other collaborations on the horizon then?
I have nothing in mind right at the moment. That just came up, like, the director of Kung Fu Panda 4 said, we would love to have a Tenacious D track at the end credits. And so we kind of came up with the Britney mashup. But I don't know, I'd love to do some Beyoncé. If we're gonna be talking about rad pop hits, I love that song, Halo. That'd make a good banger, I think.
Yeah, give us some.
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, you want me to rock right now?
Yeah.
Hold on a second. Gosh dang it, I should have practiced it before I came out here. I was just singing it in my hotel room at home. We can edit this out later. How does Halo go, the verse? It goes, you tell me that fell down. What is it? How does it go?
Remember those walls I built.
Nah, not that one, a different lyric. You're everything I need no more. It's written all over your face. Baby, I can see your halo. It's written all over your face. That ain't it. You're everything I need more.
Yeah.
That's what it was. She'll never give me the rights now.
This is going to get it on the line. This, she watches. She's a huge fan.
Music has been such a huge part of your films, your life. Does it? I mean, it must help you with this voice acting stuff because you can kind of channel the voice sort of immediately because it's an instrument you're used to wielding.
I love to rock. I love to perform music and act. And from the very beginning, I've done the combo. I started with musical theater in high school. I was Pippin in our production of Pippin.
Wow. Yes.
Everything has its season. Everything has its time. So from the very beginning, it's been the combination of the two that's been my rocket sauce. And to be truthful, I like rocking a crowd even more than I like making movies or theater. It's just like there's an electricity between performer and audience that cannot be duplicated anywhere else. But luckily, we'll be back with Tenacious D later this year.
Thanks.
In July. If you need a little dose.
Now, I feel you and I have a little bit of unfinished business. When you were in the country for the very first Kung Fu Panda movie, and you and I chatted back then.
Yeah.
You flipped me.
No.
Like I've never been flipped before.
I flipped you? There could have been a lawsuit.
No. So I was wanting to know, here we are, four movies in.
Yeah.
You've got two options.
Yeah.
A, do you think you could still flip me?
Oh, man.
Or B, could I flip you?
Again? What?
We've got the footage of the first flip to prove that it happened. History does not
really?
Lie.
Oh, my God. What is that? If I don't flip you now, if I don't flip you now, the movie's going to be a flop. I mean, look, judo is like riding a bike. You never forget. Yes, I could flip you. Wait, you're saying you want to be flipped?
I want to be flipped.
This is insanity.
Come on, let's do it. It's a lot harder to surface now.
There's
no carpet anymore.
This is crazy.
Look at what we're doing. We're old men now.
You understand that you're challenging the Kung Fu Panda.
I know.
To a flip-off.
Let's do this.
Now, let me just say this, though. Let me just say this. This is a much nicer suit than the one you were wearing 16 years ago.
He's much richer.
This is bespoke. I don't want to tear it, but by God, you need to be flipped. No, wait. It didn't feel right. Okay, hold on, hold on. Can we go slow motion
clip? Yeah, of course
clip?
We can.
And then you can speed it up in post?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, I'm not wrong.
It's just crush. It's great.
Why is the hottest part getting up again?
I would never let you flip me. I'd be afraid you'd get a hernia. I care about you too much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jack Black. Yeah! We did it. Amazing.
Bye.
Are you coming back to LA?